How can I explain myself?
Louisiana shit. Murder on the beat. Something for y'all to cut up to, you know? Yeah.
Why? What's good, ladies and gentlemen? This is Dee Dee.
CC.
Franks.
Rack.
And Fitness. We're Dee Dee and CCTV. Shout out to you guys on the building. Today, man, we got the first person coming to this channel, man. I'm so happy this man came in the chat. This is Barry White. One of my favorite songs, I Got So Much to Give, and this is a live edition in 1988. I wasn't probably even born when this shit came out. You know, I'm an 88 baby, born in 88. Shout out to the 88s. But look, today, man, we're gonna get into this fucking video. This video is supposed to be great. Low, high, low key. I love Barry White. Barry White has a lot of big story behind him. So if, when you ever get a chance, man, go check his story out. It was an interesting story what happened to him as a kid. Check out his story and see what actually happened to him to make him become an artist. And he's going to say a little bit of that in the track, in the beginning. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. Live edition, Barry White.
They say that music has more in the comic with savage beasts. What I'm gonna tell you what music does for me, because I really don't feel like a savage, and I don't feel any outrage when I hear music. I just feel
like the beginning of it, like, and then like the last part of the song, it does the same thing.
It's
like he's floating. I know he always shot when he lied. People was like, when I was growing up, he was always saying the three artists that swept the most on stage was who? Let's see if y'all know in the comments. I'm gonna say it anyway because I know y'all watching it. Yeah, y'all, I ain't wait for the three most artists who sweat a lot. She got two of them. The three artists that sweat a lot on stage in the performances. First, Luther Vandross, second Barry White, and third James Brown. She got the third one. They sweat a lot because they put a lot into their shows. These are the three male artists. I don't know about the females, the male artists. Because that when you sweating and you can tell that it's cold in the building. If you ever been to a fucking concert venue, it's cold in the building.
You can tell
they put their all into their craft. And if he wouldn't get off the stage and that man wasn't dripping with sweat, he didn't do a good job, he felt. So he showed you that. That's why he never really wiped his face so much, because he wanted you to see the passion in his music and his craft that he's giving you. He's giving you his all. His dream was when he get off the stage, he want to be at least a pound less from his body. Because he gave you his body, basically. He gave you all the sweat and tears and his... And that's what made him who he is. And niggas, females, it don't matter. Gay nigga, it don't matter. If you heard this man's voice singing, he did something to you, and not in a sexual way or nothing like that, but his voice made you feel good. It made you feel better. It made you feel like calm, like you can go through your day. And a lot of artists did that. Whitney Houston, man. Right. One of the Bobby Brown, man. Nigga voices can heal you. It'll make you feel like everything is good. And a lot of our gospel singers today does that. What's her name? Tasha Collins. Her voice, Jack. Man, these people, voices can make you feel so good about what's going on in your life. A lot of Adams. Facts. But man, let's get it, man. That was the first skip. Let's go. His team is on. My last pause on that one. He sweated so much on that video. He sweated so much in that concert that they said that the towel that he threw off the stage at the end of his show, I think he had like 5 more parts left he had to do. After that, that was 7. That was part 7. He had 5 more parts he had to do. I think it was 11-part show or 12-part show. And he threw the towel off the stage, and it had so much sweat on the towel that the towel actually landed in one of the young lady's hands. She kept that towel for like 5 years, and she fell on some hard times or whatever, and she had to sell a towel. That same towel from Barry White Sweat sold for $2 million. Amazing. Like, sweat. A towel from Barry White. Look it up. Sweat. A towel. And it was crazy. If she would have kept the towel, he died 4 years. He died a couple of years later after she sold the towel. So it was like 5 years after, before he passed, she sold the towel, and then he passed. And if she would have kept the towel, she probably would have made more from the towel. It was kind of, you know, like little Easter egg that they had online. But I like the fact that he actually put his all into these videos, into these concerts, and he's one of the best when it came to just making people feel good. What you think about it so far?
His verse just take you. He sound like the angel, like.
Facts.
I don't know,
Let us know in the comments, man. What's your favorite? What is your favorite Barry White song? I got a lot of them. I can't pick. Let me know what y'all favorite is. This is one of my favorites. Put it in the comments and let us know. Until we see you guys, make sure you hit the like button.
Subscribe.
Make sure you post notification.
Comment.
And comment what you want me to get in these seats and do. Edie.
CC.
Pranks.
Rap.